Nevertheless, I was so happy to see her. Because I love my grandma more than anything in the whole world. And when my grandma was getting old, I used to cry when she was still healthy and alive, because I used to see her skin getting wrinkly like mine is today. And I knew that meant that she's going to pass away someday, maybe not too long, maybe, I don't know when. And I'd prematurely cry and grieve as if she had already died. And there was nothing wrong with her. She was only in her 50s at that time, I think. Of course, I don't want to cry in front of her or nobody. When that hat hit me, I would run in a barn or in a granary, and I'd cry my head out, big tears just coming down, like somebody killed me or something, for her, because I thought the thoughts of her dying, I couldn't bear it. And I used to say, if grandma ever passed away, I wanted to go with her. I don't want to stay here without grandma. That's how much I love my grandma. So I did a lot of crying before she finally did die. And so that was her came in there. This was 8 years ago. And so I didn't get afraid. In fact, I was so happy to see her in her full body. And she looked at me after saying, Zalaksan, Sarakenji, Wabuyatat Sali. And then she says to me, oh, Yuli Hawana, Nahodagi Huayntakit. She says that. That means very important a message I got, or I'm worried about it. I'm carrying it. And I look at her, and she's kind of a little bit smiling. And she says, Tuka unsatun tate, awadagon skyadagi. If you do wish my request, I would like you to help me out, if you can help me out. The issue that I carry, or the message or issue I carry. And here's what she said. Oh, she's talking all Mohawk though. See, so here's what she said. I'm so worried about it. The young kids, the young boys and the young girls, our young people. Tihuanatka. That's what she said. Tihuanatka. That means they have just abandoned, parents and grandparents have abandoned their young, because they don't teach them anymore what's our belief and what's our tradition. They don't reprimand them when they do wrong. They don't scold them when they need scolding. And they don't love them when they need loving. Tihuanatkam means they just throw it away, the young. And she says, that's my problem, that's my worry. And then she says, Nihudita, in language, in English, means how poor they are, our kids. They got no more grandma, no more grandpa, no more mother, no more father, no uncle, no aunt, to teach them and protect them. And they will grow up like a horse that was just born, never saddled, never bridled, never in a barn, never nothing to be taught. And then that horse gets big. And then all of a sudden you want to put a saddle on that horse after it's grown up. That horse will throw you to the clouds, it'll buck so hard. And it'll break your bones, maybe even kill you, because it was never trained. And now if the young people who are now in problems, have lots of problems, if you try to do something like that, to talk to them now, it's too late. They already grown up like a horse that was never trained. And if you try to saddle it now, you're going to get lots of flack and trouble. It's like a wild horse. The barn door's open, they run away now. That's why I'm worried about them. Then she says to me, when you were a little boy, you were lucky where you grew up, because we always talked to you, me and others, my cousins. You had lots of grandma, you had lots of grandpa, and you heard us talking all the time, always eavesdropping on us. And we knew that you were eavesdropping, and that's, we liked that, because that's how you learned. We told you lots of things over the years until you grew up. But lots of young Native people all over the country was not fortunate like you. That's why we have to worry. She said, So I gave a gun and said, That means you will remember when you were growing, sometime you remember me, and then you remember things that I told you about life, about longhouse, about everything, Creator, what He gave to us. Would you mind that? She said, when that happens to you, you remember me and some of the things I told you and talked about. Just get any kind of a paper, one paper, and look for a pencil when you remember me when I was and you were young. And then write it down what you remember I told you about something. That's all. And then put it on your dresser or your table where nobody will touch it. Then maybe 2 days or 1 week or 1 month will pass, and then you'll see me and you'll think about me again, and you'll remember things that I told you. Get another piece of paper, even a scrap paper will do, and get a pencil and write it down what you remember, another one. And then put it on top of the other paper on your dresser or your table where nobody will touch it. And every time you do this over the years, or however long it's going to take you, keep doing that. Kele ono, a ele nyo don whiskey goes ahead don shalat suma. That means pretty soon there's a big pile of papers all written down of the things you remembered, what your grandma said. And then she said, ona unsere. On Ulihua Kwego was shot. Jinohoda was a yarane. When you have thought, the time came that you put everything down what you could possibly remember. Oh, na gunka. She said, oh, na gunka. That means at the very end. Put it on there, the last paper. Ne shenato. Ne shado shenato. And grandma said will be the name of this big pile of what you remembered.